In this video, we're going to talk about ReqIF data and its connection with Codebeamer. We're going to start with an introduction, then we're going to see how to export the data from Codebeamer into ReqIF format, how to import such files, and how we can maintain the reusability and the ease of use within Codebeamer. So first of all, what is ReqIF? So ReqIF stands for Requirements Interchange Format, which is an XML5 format that can be used to exchange requirements, along with its associated metadata between software tools from different vendors. It's possible to exchange data between Codebeamer and other systems, for example with IBM doors, via the ReqIF format. So before jumping into exporting our data, I'd like to show you how the environment is currently set up. So we are currently in the hardware requirements, and we have one custom field that we're going to use today. That's going to be the supplier scope, as you can see here on the right side. So for each requirement, we have the ability to set the supplier scope. This is going to be useful later when we are exporting the data, because we not always want to export all of our requirements, but maybe we know that some of our requirements are going to be handled by supplier one and some others are going to be handled by a different supplier. So this is going to be a field that is helping us with this filtering. Let's take a look at the last requirement. Here the scope is not set, so I can go ahead and set it to supplier two. And let's say that this requirement, I'm going to change this from supplier one to supplier three. Now, if I create a filter here, I'm going to select the supplier scope, I'm going to select supplier one, and if I hit go, I'm only going to see the requirements that are going to be handled by supplier one. I'm going to save this view because we're going to use this view later on when we are exporting the data into ReqIF format. So let's click on Save As. I'm going to name it supplier one requirements. Okay, now that we have this view, we have something to use when it comes to exporting the data to ReqIF. So let's navigate to the admin tab. Here we have the option to export. I'm going to click on export. We're going to choose ReqIF destinations. As you can see, we don't have anything here yet, meaning there's no previously configured export options. So I'm going to click on export project as a ReqIF archive. Here, we need to define the destination first. So for this, I'm going to select new destination and I'm going to name it supplier one export. The type, I'm just going to leave it as is. Click on OK. Here we have the options to select which working set or which baseline we'd like to use. I'm just going to leave it as is for now, but there's going to be a different video for each that is explaining the working sets and the baselines. Now we have to select which trackers and from which trackers which items we'd like to export. So here I'm not going to select the customer requirement specification, but we're going to use our hardware requirements. For this, we have some fields previously defined. We can also add more fields. For example, we have our supplier scope here, which I'm not going to add because it doesn't really make sense when it comes to exporting this to a supplier. But what I'd like to focus on is that we have the option to select a tracker view. So currently, as we have here in the configuration, all of our requirements would be exported. And this is where our view comes handy, because with that view, we can basically apply the filtering so that only the items that are flagged as supplier one scope are going to be included in this ReqIF export. So I'm going to click on select tracker view. And in my private views, I have my supplier one requirements view. So I'm going to select that. Now, as you can see, the supplier one requirements view appears here, meaning only those items are going to be included that are visible when this view is selected. So we're going to filter on the supplier scope field basically. Apart from defining which fields we'd like to include, we also have the options to select references or associations. So for example, in this scenario, I can select to include all of the requirements for the linked hardware requirements as well, which is going to add the hardware design tracker and some fields by default. Of course, here we have the options to select the tracker view as well, but we're just going to leave it as is. Now that our configuration is complete, I'm going to hit OK. Now, the job has started. So once the export is finished, we are ready to download the file. I have the option here to click on Now in the bottom right corner, which is going to download the file for me. Going back to what I mentioned earlier, now if we click on Export and check the ReqIF destinations, we're going to have our supplier 1 export here, meaning that whenever we'd like to exchange some data with our supplier 1, we are not required to reconfigure everything. We can just use the pre-configured supplier 1 export. And if we click on that, we're going to see the past exports or the export history. We can exactly see how many items were exported from each different trackers and which trackers were used. Now let's close this and let's see the export again. Project as ReqIF archive. And here we have our supplier 1 export with all the pre-configured details. So this is how you export data to ReqIF format from Codebeamer. Now let's see how to import ReqIF data. I'm going to use a different data source so that we can see the mapping and how to create all the connections when we are doing the importing for the first time. So just to reiterate, we are in the admin tab, and here we have the option to import ReqIF. I'm going to choose an existing file, the demo ReqIF file that I have here. In this, I have a few custom requirement specifications. And for these, I have to set some fields here. Notice that the source was not picked up because this file hasn't been used yet. So I can create a new source. For example, I'm going to name it supplier 2. This way, this can be reused later. So once we create the mapping for our second supplier, we can reuse that anytime in the future. So the tracker is met, so we are importing to the customer requirement specification tracker. For the name, we're going to use the name, for the key, the key. The rest we're going to ignore, and for the items, the name is already set, the status is set, same goes with the description. The other fields, we're going to just leave it as is. So now let's click on OK. And now the importing has started. Now let's go to our trackers and open up the customer requirements specifications tracker. And here we can see a lot of items that has just been imported from our ReqIF file. If I go back to the admins tab, similarly to what we've seen with the exporting, if I go to the import and check the ReqIF sources, we're going to have our supplier 2, where we can see the import history, how many items were created, to what tracker. Of course, we can see the list of the items that were imported into the tracker. And if I click on one of these IDs, that item is going to be opened up. So this is how to import ReqIF to Codebeamer.